with the only tri-state forecast that's independently certified most accurate. Here's meteorologist Eric Zarnitz.
You know, Curtis, on a day like today, I have no idea what sounds any better than chili with these cold temperatures outside and a nice hot bowl of that steaming chili. But today, another cold one, more snow, more cold weather. You know the routine by now. You can see WLWT Power 5 Live Radar, a few very light snow showers up around Hamilton in Butler County and also over towards Clinton County, a few light snow showers as well. Most of us are actually seeing a scene like this, a gorgeous sunset. We saw some sun this afternoon. That helped us out just a little bit. But now as the sun is dropping, it looks like we're going to see more cold air in tonight. Current temperature 21 degrees. Our winds are out of the west northwest at 22 miles an hour. Not only is that giving us a wind chill in the single digits, but it's also picking up that really light powdery snow and it's whipping it this way and that. So be careful if you are traveling. We do have a winter weather advisory in effect simply because of the snow that's already on the ground. It's that light fluffy stuff and it could easily blow back on the roadways and of course create some more problems, even reduced visibilities from time to time tonight. Some more temperatures, 21 degrees in Aurora, 25 degrees in Falmouth, 20 degrees in Wilmington, 20 in Hillsborough, and 24 degrees in West Union. So there's our system rolling off to the east. You can see our skies currently clearing out, but what the satellite doesn't show is all of that wind streaming in from the northern plains. Now there is some good news here. Tomorrow we're going to see a bit of a warm front at least approach the tri-state. So temperatures by the afternoon are going to warm up, I think, into the 30s, perhaps even closing in on 40 degrees. However, we have the chance for snow. Actually, a few chances for snow. One in the morning, and then another one as we head Sunday night into Monday morning, and that one's going to be followed by some bitter, bitter cold air. Temperatures tomorrow starting off in the single digits. I do think we warm up to a high of 37 degrees, and again, here's that first chance for snow. It looks like most locations to the north of Cincinnati could pick up about an inch or so, and then as we head into tomorrow night, our Arctic cold front's going to steamroll its way into the tri-state, and that's going to give us another chance for some light snow, but it's the winds and the cold weather that are really going to steal the headlines. So again, tomorrow, 50s, 60s down to our south. We get a very small taste of that in the afternoon. And then this sort of pile of cold air is just going to come sloshing southward, giving us the coldest reading so far this year as we head into Tuesday morning and Wednesday morning as well. I know not the news you want to hear, but we do have some warmer weather. In fact, I think we're going to be freezing a couple of times this week. So at least things appear as though they're going to start to get better by the end of the week. Futurecast showing mostly clear skies for the next couple of hours. Late tonight, we'll see those clouds starting to build in and then snow overspreading the tri-state, especially to the north of Cincinnati. That's where we have our best chance of picking up 1, maybe even 2 inches in some spots. That can't be ruled out. During the afternoon, I think we're going to be on the drier side of things. Maybe a few rain showers here and there as temperatures are going to be above that freezing mark. And then again tomorrow night, that's when our Arctic boundary comes through, giving us another chance for snow, some high winds, and some very cold air as we head through your Monday. So tonight, 3 degrees, partly cloudy skies. Those will be increasing with those clouds by later on tonight. Tomorrow morning, some snow. It should be all wrapped up by the afternoon, 37 degrees with mostly cloudy skies. And again, here's your 7-day forecast. Check out that high on Monday. Doesn't look bad, right? 30 degrees. But that's the high just after midnight. That temperature is going to be falling all day long. And then as we head into Tuesday, 10 below zero to start the day, a high only of 7, 4 below on Wednesday. But Curtis, I promised you some warmer weather. And there it is, close to 40 by next Saturday.